इतना सा फर्क है कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में, इतना सा फर्क है एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में, मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में कि अभी तो बस शुरुआत है, किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन की कवर पेज पे होने में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वीआईपी सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है वही कल जमीन पर तो था, पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी, एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है, इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है, धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है, ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है, एक कदम एक छलांग एक बाजी एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हां मैं बना हूं फिजाओं के, कि हां मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क है, धूप छांव में फर्क बस इतना सा है, तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं, फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया 20 years of ideas.
Good afternoon, one and all. 22 years of creating difference in market, and we have facts and figures to prove the statement. 40,000 deals, and we have 4,000 brands internationally and nationally served by us, presence in 17 cities, and journey is still going on. With this introduction of Franchise India, I welcome you to the 56th edition of Business Opportunity Chai webinar series, an initiative where we give a platform to all our premium brands to showcase their brands to our potential business buyers so that they can select their dream brands. And today we are welcoming our panel member, Mr. Gaurav Marya, who is the chairman at Franchise India Group, is an author and entrepreneur. We also welcome our second panel member, Ms. Sonia Chaudhary. She is the MD at Franchise India Brands Limited and director at Remax India. And both are leading team of business consultants, helping brands to expand their business and investors to select their brands. Today, the brand of the day is German Laundry. And we have privilege that we have Amber and Tanvi, brother-sister partnership, joining us today, talking about their great brand. German Laundry, established 7 years ago with a vision of making, with a mission of becoming a leader in market, and they are serving services like dry cleaning, laundry, steam press, color gardening, brightening, and whatnot. They are 100% enabled company, and they have over 1 lakh satisfied customer. I formally welcome Amber and Tanvi, but Amber, I would request before we start, if we can have a short, sweet video from your side talking about your brand. Over to you, Amber.
Hello guys, I'm Amber Rahul, Managing Director of German Laundry. I'll just share a small video about how our laundry works with the whole process, which is like an advanced, completely new process. I'll just share a video with you guys. Just have a look. There was a video like about how we process our clothes, and that is the whole process, advanced technology, advanced detergents, advanced machines, what we use in general day-to-day life. And we have started our brand in 2011 from Mumbai, and we started with one shop in Mahim, which was it's in Mumbai, and further we started we started getting good response all over. We start getting people from coming from different parts of city, from South Bombay, from Thane, from like Bandra to Santa Cruz, like all over the city. We were getting customers from all over the city. So we thought like, why can't we just start expanding a brand? So we started like few shops and stores in South Bombay. Like, we started in Kulapa, we started in Bandra, we started in Walkeshwar, Altamount Road, and we started getting so much good response all over that we thought like we'll expand more. And it happened that we started with 12 stores all over Bombay, and then we have started getting very good response. We started getting like a lot of celebrities like Deepika Padukone, Sachin Tendulkar, Deepak Parekh, and lot of Bollywood stars and fashion designers and lot of many people. So looking at that, we thought like we should expand in different city too. So we started like 2 years back, we started in Delhi with 3 stores right now, currently running 3 stores. And then we were getting a lot of inquiries in general, like, we want a franchisee. So we'll try to expand ourselves. But slowly we thought like, we should experiment by giving some franchises over. So around 3 years, 4 years back, we started with a franchise store in Badala, Sain, Lower Parel and Pawai, and it happened to be like what success. We thought they will start getting their ROI, everything back within like 1.5-2 years. They actually started doing good in like their 6th-8th month itself, because they were concentrating on the each store and they were concentrating on their locality itself. And it happened to happen that like they were really really happy, and they started asking for other stores also. So there are other few franchisees, they're so happy with it that they want to take more and more stores altogether. So we thought, why can't we just like, give it a try? And Mr. Gaurav Maria was, we had spoken before. So we thought like, let's give Franchise India like, a very good start. Will be a very good start for us, because they have a huge market share all over India. So we thought, why don't we just start with them? Hello. And so I'll just share a small presentation with you. Just a second. So like I said, we started in 2011. We are into advanced dry cleaning and laundry, where our our machinery and our detergents and our chemicals, everything is imported from Germany itself. Hence the name is called German Laundry. We are the leading dry cleaning and laundry brand in Mumbai and Delhi currently. And it's all because of quality and the customer satisfaction, which we literally focus on. And the staff training and like technology and everything, we keep improvising every day, every month, whatever we can. We keep doing seminars, we keep doing technology upgrades, we keep training our staff every 2 months, what is new, what's not, and everything else. So we have like, our standards, we have lots of quality checks. Like after every process, we have a quality check. So once the clothes come in, we generally have a look generally at the store level, at the billing counter itself, we identify if there are any stains, if there's any holes, any stone parts or anything. Post we do that, like once we start processing, we have seven process meaning, where we start with the inspection and diagnosis. Like I said, we start with the pre-treatment, which is like stain removal and like different other pre-treatment processes. In stain removal, we have like more than 20 different stain removal detergents and chemicals. which each and every chemical which we use or detergent which we use for stain removing has different unique to remove the stains right now. So like, so blood stain has a different chemical altogether. Like for rust stain is different, for food stain is different. It's completely different for all those stains. Then we do our dry cleaning and laundry process, which again, we use our hydrocarbon machines. We use our, we don't use normal dry cleaning machines. We use hydrocarbon, which is the latest technology right now. And we do not use any perk or anything which harms your clothes or anything. We also then post that after every step, which is from inspection, free treatment, stain removal, cleaning, we do a quality check if your clothes is fine or not. If it is just like, you know, something is wrong with your clothes, or the clothes is not gonna like happen to anything, so we stop the process and we do some other treatment to it. Then we have our steam pressing and finishing, where we do use steam press only. We do not use any harsh irons or anything. Like these steam press machines are so advanced that even if you try to burn the clothes, it won't burn. It's just like very advanced, so it won't even spoil the clothes. It just gives you a crispy ironing quality. And again, before packing, we do a quality check if everything is, and we ensure that everything is fine. Post that, we do packing and goes back to the customers. Like I said, we have 6-step inspection process. After every process, we do a quality check to see if everything is fine. We have our German collaboration with German partners. So they come visit us, like, you know, every time, every 6 months or every year. We get everything, train us with new technology or new machines which is there, or which or new detergents or chemicals which we can use, or like, you know, quality, how everything. So they come and help us and like train us in general. So like I said, in Bombay and Delhi we have huge, in Bombay we have 5,000 square feet and in Delhi we have 5,000 square feet centralized cleaning centers. And so it's easier for us to use centralized because we have around 14 stores in Mumbai. So it's easier to do it centralized unit. And Delhi, we just started with 3 and we want to expand more. We started with Gurgaon store as well. So we have more than 10 years of experience in the laundry segment and dry cleaning segment. We have crossed more than 2 lakh customers currently. And we have completely 100% IT enabled. From the step one to last step, everything's automated and well tracked. We have an in-house software where from step to step you come to know where the clothes is, and we have linked that with our app where you can also see like what process your clothes are into. Like in case you are checking, you can pay online, you can see, you can request for a pickup or a drop, or you can do a payment as well. Then we have like, these are the locations in Bombay right now. We have from South Bombay to suburbs and as well as eastern suburbs, and we plan to start in Vashi, Navi Mumbai, Thane, Pune, Nagpur, Nasik, in Maharashtra, and all over India, pan India, as well as like, you know, in different cities like Bangalore, Delhi, we already have Chandigarh, and many more. So we are planning to start in Indore, also Chennai, Kolkata, Ahmedabad, and many more other. So we have like given, we have for franchisees, we give the most accurate training for all the franchisee partners from day one, from how to handle clothes, how to handle the process, how to handle machineries, how to handle the staff, how to train the staff, everything from A to Z. We train the franchisees and we make sure that we set up the whole shop and store and everything for them from scratch to till, and we try to remain with them. We are we train them and we are there with them throughout the time till they are settled, and we try to run the operations for minimum like, you know, 2 to 3 months till they are also confident that they can run their own franchisee. So we help from day to day, any problem or anything happens to, like, you know, if they're running with any queries or anything, we are on call and we have a team for to answer all the queries from franchisee if they have any problems with any sort of clothes or any sort of customer or anything generally. But our training itself is such foolproof that generally franchisee itself gets that confidence to run the whole franchisee within a month or two. And post that, it's just like a general quality check which we keep doing with the franchisees to see if our quality is still maintained with the brand and all. So we have won a lot of awards also. Currently, we have like won 3 awards for the best practice and the best dry cleaning awards in Mumbai. We have technical support from technical team to check out your machines and like no matter what technical glitches you have, we have the whole manual and SOPs ready to deal with it. We have a very unique service which is called Hot Pitch All services, where you have like bridal gowns and lehengas and which are like, you know, weighing like 30-40 kilos, a huge, very expensive, like, you know, lehengas of like 5 lakhs, 10 lakhs, and a lot of these embellishments and things on the lehengas. What we do is like we have a very unique special program and special service where we can actually like clean this without harming even 0.1% to it and giving it back to the customers as clean and as fresh as they had purchased it and as crispy, so that during their wedding or whatever special event, they can look good at it.
Thank you, Amber. It was very clear. So let's start with some little detailing out in the business model. You know, so if you can really give some microeconomics of one single unit in terms of sales, how many garments have to be coming, how it needs to process, what kind of team members you need to have. So let's go a little deeper into a single unit business model. Okay. And yeah.
So we have like 4 different type of franchises available. We have like the master franchisee where someone can acquire the entire city or state. Then we have small collection centers where the franchisee has to just collect the clothes and deliver the clothes, while the clothes will be like will be washed and ironed and packed by us. The third option is collection center with ironing, where the franchisee can just give the collect the clothes, give us to for wash, and we give it back and they will clean, they will iron and they will pack it by themselves and give it to customer, which has very good advantage of ironing because a lot of people come only for ironing, so you can get that business as well. Then we have collection center with washing and ironing, which we are preferring to franchise to everyone. So that it requires like, you know, you get everything in-house from where we have a concept of live cleaning where people can see what is happening in the store. We will set up the whole machinery, we will set up the whole stacker, as well as the ironing, as well as the counters. Everything will be like set up by us, and you have to just like the training and everything will be given by us, and you have to just like run the show. So coming from smaller franchise, which is collection center, you will require barely 3 people, three staff members, which includes your store managers and your pickup delivery boy. Then collection centers, you will require again 2 managers as well as 1 pickup delivery boy and 1 ironer who will do it, will be doing the pressing. And for collection center again, you will be required maximum 6 people, which is like again 2 managers and your washing and ironing ironing man and drivers and then pickup boy. And for mother franchisee, which is like master franchisee, you require other training and other, like, you know, another managing people.
Sure. So let's understand the master. Master would put up a mother center where the entire processing would happen. What does it cost? And what kind of master are you looking for? A state, or are you looking for a city? What kind of master you're looking at?
We are looking at city. It'll be preferable for city because people can concentrate, like, you know, the franchisee can concentrate on city is much easier than going for the state. So the mother franchisee would, like, you know, cost you around 72 lakhs max, but the area required for it is also tiny, with 1 mother store, which is like, which will cater to your dry cleaning, which will cater your washing, ironing and everything from one place itself. With your initial investment from interiors to everything should not cross more than 72 lakhs. And then the same mother franchise, the master franchisee, can open his own collection centers all over the city. And the collection centers will be supported by the mother franchisee, mother store, which will be one in the city. And as the franchisee grows, we also make provisions for the franchisee to set up more and more machineries. Like, we don't want the franchisee to be stuck with, like, you know, like lower capacity. As the capacity, as the business grows, we increase the machinery, and which is a good thing. So we can make it a central unit and mother store as well.
So just to clarify, and you can correct me, Amber, wherever I'm going wrong, in terms of, say, you are in Ahmedabad.
Correct.
You have a one mother center, which would cost you about 70 odd lakh rupees, which would have facilities of full dry cleaning. Dry cleaning has a separate equipment. You have a laundry facility, you have a ironing facility, and a lot of other facilities available in the mother. Then, as a master, you would either open up your own collection points all over Ahmedabad, which means that Ahmedabad alone can have, say, 15 collection points or more.
Yes.
You know, city like that can have even about 20 collection points also. Or you would sub-franchise. Sub-franchise, if you sub-franchise, then you'd share the fee. Say a sub-franchisee is only 5 odd lakh rupees or 7 lakh rupees investment. And so there is an upfront franchise fees, which you would get some share, and the master franchisee would get some share, and the brand German Laundry would get some share.
So,
but all the clothes would be picked up from the collection points to be brought to the mother entire thing. It would be processed in 24 hours, sent back to the collection points. And collection points can be also three types. One, only collecting and delivering to the consumer. That's one point, which can be very, very small. It can be anything 100 square feet kind of a format. It, then the next collection points are collection and ironing, where you have a you know, ironing facility available. So you send the clothes for washing or dry cleaning. When they come back, you iron that, deck it up, and then give it to the consumer. Third also is a model where you would have a collection and washing, which means that you have a washer and a decker available in the entire thing, washer and dryer. Where people can come and see. It's more like a laundromat.
Live staining.
Live staining. There's a stacker there. So stacker would, you can just load your dyeing. It's by kg or, washing by kg or by, garment. And then they can iron and then they do it. So this is the best model where you really make money is the dry cleaning. And German Laundry is known for dry cleaning. They're a very strong brand in Mumbai. Now I'll come back to Amber, because we had a discussion and I particularly requested you to really open up for our investors some running outlets, because I understand that you run company-owned outlets, a lot of them. And I actually, on the behalf of franchising, I requested him, because at this stage, a lot of investors are always looking at some kind of, when they invest, they have a risk in mind, and especially the COVID times.
Correct.
To do something which is more proven and more structured. So I actually went out to Amber and said, can we give company-owned outlets to franchisee where there is a performance already known? We know that there is some performance going on, and there is already customer base which is established, because whenever you open up a new laundry and dry cleaning, normally it takes at least 1 year to get that customer base, and it takes a lot of effort investment. But once you get the customer base, the customer keeps coming back to you and on a regular basis. So I requested him that should you transfer, he agreed as a special case for our investors at Franchise India that we are able to give some running outlets which are already profitable to transfer it to franchisees. So I would come back to Amber, and maybe Tanvi, start with you. You have a background on which are the outlets we can talk about, and if you can go a little specific on which markets you have outlets and which outlets you can perform and transfer. And that would be good.
Yeah, so we have stores which are running since 10 years, like a Mahim store, a Bandra store is running since more than 10 years. Few other stores are just starting running since 5-6 years. Actually, all the stores which are company owned are more than 5 years. And we have completed, we have done our own marketing. We have done our own, we ran the stores and everything. We did our own building the whole customer base and everything in that specific area. So we have all the ready customers and ready profitable business which is going on, like you said. So we, like I said, 2-3 years back, we thought of giving franchisee, but actually it turned out to be very well. And because micromanaging those franchisee is very successful, and you actually turn out to be get success in 6-7 months itself if you actually market and concentrate on one thing itself. So what we thought, Mr. Gaurav said, like, you know, why can't we just give the current running outlets also like on franchisees? So we were thinking that way. Then I was like, yeah, actually we can do that, because if we micromanaging like around 12 stores and some one person is micromanaging one per store, the amount which we are actually customers we have can concentrate on one store and can concentrate on customers itself and like grow the business to another level. Because it will
right
be
now, what we are, see, we have already say 12 stores currently running. Okay. We are having overload of things going even in Delhi. So we are not able to even micromanage every store. So this is actually a good idea that Gaurav had spoken to Amber, if we could give running stores, then the kind of concentration the owners can put, the franchisee owners, the kind of effort they will put per store will be also different, you know. So, and also if someone is willing to take a new franchise in a new city, we will be doing handholding completely from start to the end. Till the time they're confident that they can handle the store on their own, we will be completely part of them throughout the journey, you know, whether it is the training or being there for all the necessary things. For now, there are some stores we have worked on in Mumbai, which we could do franchising right away. Depends upon the request and the investment also involved, because every store, the size is different and the customer base is different. So it will, you know, we wouldn't be able to vaguely tell you right now which store is ready to give outsourced immediately. But the kind of pricing would be completely different. Like Bandra has a very large customer base, whereas there are some stores which are opened currently, you know, newly opened. So for that, we'll have to discuss internally. There are a few stores which we have shortlisted, which can go on franchisee model immediate basis. I think Amber will be able to tell you better which are the stores which we have decided.
Yeah, I'll check.
So I thought Amber said very rightly, I always advocate that companies should transfer their company-owned stores into franchising.
Yeah.
Two reasons. One, it brings in better efficiency.
Yeah.
Entrepreneur and operator owner drives the business, he brings in more efficiency. And out efficiency would mean you would be able to manage in lesser staff and your profitability would go up and things like that. Second, I always say that company also, if they run company-owned stores and they're franchising, they always keep focusing too much on their company-owned store because they have writing. If they release themselves from there, they concentrate on the brand, they concentrate on the sport, they concentrate on more expansion and structure. So it works both ways. You might lose a little bit of profitability of your company-owned investment, but it is in long term, it gives a good opportunity to do that. So, Amber, you want to pick up a few cities which you want to really take up as a few locations which you want to really give a shot that we can offer to our investors?
Yeah, we have shortlisted few stores as in Mumbai currently where we can give franchisees to, current stores to as franchisees. So, we have... except for one or two, we have shortlisted, like, you know, except for two ones, we are giving all the, we have decided to give all the other current running outlets as franchisees. So we can, you can go on the website and there are like around 14 different stores where you can start your own franchisee right away.
We could transfer it.
So very interesting. So these are businesses which are very rare for everybody to know, because company owned outlets have a lot of investment gone in. The market is established, the location is established, the consumer base is established, they're already profitable, and you get a profitable business which is transferred to you. So asset would be transferred to you on the valuation. There would be obviously a goodwill which they have built because the business is already profitable, and they would also work with you to see how the lease can be transferred or it can be licensed to you to run and operate the business. All that structuring, Franchise India would be able to help in doing it. So I strongly feel that investors should look at that buying the existing stores, because that gives you an opportunity. And a lot of locations where they are not available, I would say the opportunity can be starting from a master, set up your mother outlet, and then you can able to set that. It's a very strong brand name. And if you are in Bombay, you cannot miss them. And especially I have been passing through their shop almost every time I'm in Bandra. I have to pass through there. It's an iconic address, you know, and it is an iconic brand name, and everybody in Bombay knows, and nobody can miss, including Salman Khan.
Yeah, that's true. So we have, actually, we have currently like lot of celebrities which keep coming with, like, you know, they keep recommending each other. we keep getting them, like, you know, saying like, Mr. Salman recommended your brand, Mr. Deepika, Miss Deepika, like, you know, like we keep getting like these lot of, because of these word of mouth marketing generally.
Absolutely, absolutely. And it's opinion makers who make a brand, and you are on the spot where almost all opinion makers in and influential makers in Bombay are always being your users. Good to have you. I would like to invite now Sonia. Sonia, you want to take up questions? A lot of questions are coming in. And just if you are interested in taking the business, I've also put in the, my, you know, our business hotline, which we've launched now. So keep sharing your profile on the business hotline. We will make sure that we will be able to connect with you, with Amber and Tanvi immediately, so that your interest is well taken care. Over to you, Sonia.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Amber and Tanvi. I think the presentation, when I was going through, we also have one of your outlets very close to our office in Delhi also. That is also one of the locations. I'm sure a lot of our team members also cross every day. And that was the one I was referring last time when we had spoken to. So Amber, I'll take some questions which people in fact have asked. But before that, I would also maybe add to whatever I think you put across in the presentation, also for our viewers. And laundry is one of the oldest school industries, you know, which has integrated technology very quickly, unlike many other industries which were old but had not integrated. And especially the on-demand industry in the recent years has a big element of the technology into it. And overall, this sector, I would say organized, while largely still unorganized like many other industries. But the last 5 years, I've actually seen the prominence of organized players. And which started with many players like you who were there in the industry, worked for long and started creating these clusters like Bombay, UAE, popular, and you have a big consumer base and repeat consumers that come in. And one of the biggest issues for players in this industry has always been scaling up because of you know, operational intensity of business which is required both at the back end and the front end, because of which many players have not been able to scale up. And I also feel that today even the profile of franchisees are becoming very, very important. We do work with the many other brands in the same category, and also a lot of promoters who have come in this particular category of laundromats are this very, you know, educated lot, and that is happening globally also. There are companies like Rins in USA, which is started by Harvard graduate. We have companies in India started by IITians. And there are also many franchisees who come from this background. So I feel profile of the franchisees is also very big, important element in making these units profitable or successful, I would say efficient. And the second most important part is being hyper local. You need to be in the market, you need to be in the neighborhood, because this is a repeat use category business and a lot of convenience which matters to the consumer. But I'll take questions which I think some of people have also asked repeatedly. The first, I would like to really explain, you know, how the entire cost of services works. You know, so it's a CCD from collection, cleaning to delivery. There are a lot of processes involved broadly amongst these three processes. What exactly is the cost of service is my question, and what kind of absolute margins one can achieve in a business like this? And second, because logistics and especially reverse logistics in on-demand, you also do a lot of on-demand business. How big is that issue, and what part of the margins does logistics and reverse logistics consume for you in servicing your clients?
So, like you asked, like the logistics and reverse logistics, we always take that into consideration with our pricing. So, whenever we do pricing per city, as per city, we consider all expenses and all the expenditures which is there. So, we add that logistics and reverse logistics in it. And when it comes to revenue, it's just like around, you can have around 30%, 25 to 30% depending amount the business, what you're doing. Depending on the other expenses like your rent and your salaries and everything, it should not come below 25% and 30%. It can go higher depending on the efficiency which you run the stores.
Okay, and because I was seeing you do a lot of these segments, and they must be a very wide consumer base for you. And the industry, like any other industry, would work from maybe a value consumer to a budget to a premium. and what percentage of value consumer you have, and which is that segment you think the franchisee needs to focus the most? You know, some would be more repeat businesses, but some of these categories would be high on the margins. So what is your maybe 20-80 value proposition for a store, which brings the maximum number of or maybe, you know, that big revenue stream for you?
So we have what consumers, what the franchisees can concentrate is on corporate tie-ups. Like, you know, we have a lot of big brands like Gucci, Louis Vuitton, like a lot of these other brands. Then we have like news channels. Then we have media, like another media channels. Plus we have like film cities, like production houses. And a lot of these corporate plans, which actually fetches like very good business. Then we have a lot of HNIs, which does their laundry every, like, you know, every alternate days or something, like, you know, every week or something. They come with a bunch of, they give us very good business generally. So we have to focus on people who are dependent on, like, you know, laundries, outsourcing their laundries rather than doing home, because they do not get time to do their laundry. They do not have time to, some, like, a lot of people right now have, everyone has actually shifted from wearing to a very high brand clothes. Everyone shops at High Street right now, and everyone has a, like, you know, very good branded clothes. Like, so they do not want to risk by giving washing at home or giving it local dry cleaners or some random laundry guy who comes at home and risk the quality of the clothes, because that's what happens.
So this is all more than the services. It is the experience that people get end of the day, you know, the clothes you need for your office regular clothes also, you know, what you, the kind of service a regular laundry can give you vis-a-vis what we can give is completely different, you know, the ironing part or anything. So nowadays I've, you know, initially if you ask me 10 years back, laundry was a luxury. Only few could afford it. But now it is like everyone wants that service, because everyone, you know, indulges in expensive brands. Nobody, the time has changed, you know. If you ask me 10 years back, it was just for special clothes we would use laundry. Today, even if you buy your regular clothes, you wish to have it, you know, laundered outside with the fear, you know, I might have some problems if I wash it home. So majorly, most of them nowadays depend getting their clothes washed outside than doing it home, you know, depending on your house help or anybody. So I think our customers are increasing day by day because of this. Honestly, there are few reviews we have got. You know, we had one seminar done in our master shop wherein we were just introducing people on the services and everything. Just very funny, where we had few reviews where people have come to us and said, "Hey, I have shirts which are now 5 years old. I don't know what to do because they are just like that. You know, I've been washing them at your store, and there was a time we would buy those Louis Philippe shirts every 2 years or, you know, 3 years. Now these are 5 years old. I don't know what to do. I don't have to even buy new clothes, you know." So that is the kind of the age of your clothes increase, you know, taken care properly. And of course, if you're buying it from stores like Louis Philippe or Gucci, anything, they are tend to stay longer with you if taken care properly. And that's exactly what we do here.
Thanks, I'll take one question. You know, while we did talk about the beauty where your existing centers and outlets can be taken over the profitable running ones, I also see some of our viewers who are currently running maybe their own laundromats in their cities. Would you also be looking at conversion franchising? And if yes, what are the implications for a franchisee? You know, what kind of investment he needs to make over and above of what he has made, one. And second, what locations would you be willing to go? So if it is a conversion, would you be okay going outside Bombay and Delhi?
Yeah, we will have a different, different sector for that. Not exactly coming under German laundry, but a different model for such conversions. But we are open for conversions also.
And this
because
is
there are many coming, you know, we see always there are many coming, you know, every alternate we see completely different. What, when we started, there was nobody except for one or two, you know, now there are many coming. Sustaining for so many is not going to be easy. So the only solution is we have to have this model of converting them, you know, but then we have a completely different idea, and the brand model is be completely different for such conversion.
Yeah, for such conversion. We will be training them again. We'll be like checking like what machinery, what detergents, the chemicals they're using, we have to convert them, we have to train them, we have to do everything. That could be very much possible, and we are open for that too.
Okay, now, because, you know, now that I'd like to understand what kind of ROI is, because we're talking about two models. One is unit and the other is a master model. What kind of return on the investment an investor can have when running a unit? And second, for a master franchisee and also for a unit franchisee, what kind of gestation time does it take? You know, how many months would it take for him to actually break even, one, and second, to actually get the return on the investment back? So what is that gestation time for both these models? And if you can also help us in understanding what number of outlets ideally should come under a master franchisee to make his operations efficient.
So coming to mother franchisee, we have, like, you know, the payback period should be around 1 year, 11 months to like 2 years. And the ROI on that is, like, you can get anything around 90 to 95% or more, depending on, like, you know, how scale up do you sub franchise and like other factors as well. And when it comes to like other lower models, which is like collection centers with ironing and washing everything, again the payback period for that is little shorter, which is like depends like on the model. It goes from 1 year, 3 months or so, or say 1.5 years or so or more. And the, again, average ROI for that is also actually a little more, because your investment is a little lower on that. So your investment, like, you know, ROI can go to around 150% as well. And
but because I also have questions which I'm seeing, while it's a retail setup we talked about, and you did talk about some corporations or companies or brands you mentioned that you also work with. I have a question saying, then can we also cater, apart from the retail neighborhood, can they also cater to hospitals? And if I need to widen that, can there also be some kind of institutional business, one? And second, what kind of a setup would that require? Because, you know, the kind of machinery infrastructure would be comparatively different.
Correct. For that, we do institutional clients like hotels and salons and a lot of other brands, industries as such. But we don't do hospitals, because it's first thing it comes to, like, you know, hygiene and everything, and customers who are actually giving, they're close with a lot of trust. They think it's, like, you know, it's in a hygienic mode. So we do not accept actually hospital tools. In case, like, we have been approached by hospitals quite a few times for, like, you know, running their stores or whatever, running the machineries and running the clothes in generally. So we do not do that. So for them, we have specially, like, you know, send our technicians and a technician guide or something over there, like, showed us what to do, how to manage, and, like, you know, train them how to clean the hospital clothes with a lot of other, you know, blood stains and a lot of other things with them. So we had to give them training.
So what we do with hospital is, like, we try to set it in-house for them.
Yeah.
And do the hand-holding, instead of having those clothes come to our outlet where you have, our customers also sending their clothes. We don't find that viable. So what we try to do is set up, like how hotels have their in-house laundries, we try to set up their the cleaning, everything in-house. So then that becomes easier for them. Transportation, because the quantum is way too big, you know. So that becomes more easier. So now, since we have one or two, it's better to just set it up for them in-house, you know. So we know from what department clothes come and how we could tackle different clothes for different things.
Okay. And, how competitive is the pricing is one thing I'm sure everybody wants to know, because there are many players in one city. And even the same neighborhood have a lot of your competition also operating. What kind of competitive pricing you have is one question. And second, because customer plays a very important role, what kind of activities you do to engage your customer and retain him? You know, because acquisition a big cost, one. Right. And second, which is very important, is to also retain your existing customer with you. So what do you do as a company to engage and retain your customers?
So in this competition, I'll just let you know, like, you know, we have like barely 2-3 competitors in Bombay and Delhi, which is, like, you know, giving as good quality as we are. The quality, if you compare to other brands, you can check, like, you know, we have asked some consumers also, like, to do an experiment, like, you can check other brands as well and see the quality. So in the end, the consumers have returned to us. A lot of consumers will change their brands which they used to give it to, because they were not that great quality or something. So they always switch. There are a lot of consumers who switch from one particular brand to us, one thing, because of the quality, no doubt the quality is really good. And second thing is like the pricing we have kept purposely like around 20 to 30% lesser than what our competitors are offering. With good quality and lesser price, we are attracting a lot of good customers.
And what would be your repeat case for customers? What is that percentage of your repeat case? You've been old enough, but give me a comparison of your oldest outlet in Bombay, which is prime location, and yeah, maybe higher number of repeat case, and give me an average case of typical outlet. What would that be? And how long does it take to reach that point?
So we have regular customers. Who are customers? They're not one-time customers. There are very few, I think 5% customers who are just like, you know, one time they'll come and give it back. But all other customers are repetitive. Like, you know, they keep coming every week, at least once a week or twice a week, or some even come like twice a week. So depending on the customer as well, like, you know, how much clothes does he wear, like, you know, they outsource or wash it at home. And to retain the customers, we do a lot of activities. Like, you know, we give a lot of offers, like 5+1, or we give a lot of offers, like, you know, prepaid customer, you can prepay for 5,000, but you get 6,000 worth, like, you know, dry cleaning clothes, and then you can pay 10,000, you get 12,000 worth dry cleaning, and a lot of other such activities you keep running month to month, or like, you know, to attract more customers. So we just, because once customers prepay, they have that trust, as well as they think, like, you know, they just keep coming, they don't have to like hassle about or worry about like how much you have to pay, what do I do. So, and it's a good thing for us also, because we get prepaid rather than like, you know, waiting for a few days and then getting like, you know, liquidity in the market, in the business, which is a very advantage point for us also.
And what do you expect as far as the franchisee is concerned? You know, while you do a lot of digital marketing and you're doing that, especially in places like Bombay, you already have existing outlets, but what exactly is the expectation from a franchisee when it comes to maybe building his local customer base, and what kind of involvement in marketing is he advised to?
So we actually, as new stores open, we actually will help the franchisee with all the marketing supplies, like, you know, from where to, with strategy, like how to reach the local customers, how we can do overall city marketing, and all other support we do actually help the franchisee with. And initial, whatever offers where we can, like, you know, launch with the franchisee, that specific store, for example, to say we start in Pune city. So what offers can we give in Pune city to attract the most customers in the first initial 3-4 months when we are hammering everyone with marketing with our brand name? So that's how we try to gain our customers in like first 6 months, how much we can, like, you know, very good offers. So, and we provide from digital to everything, no matter like if say franchisee wants to does a different kind of marketing, or no matter what ideas they have, we always take consideration to that. And then we always help them with whatever marketing they want to do. So we have the whole support from for marketing, for strategies, and we help with everything with marketing.
I see one of the questions which says, what is, you know, while it takes about a year and a half plus for somebody to get the ROI, but what is the average monthly sales one can expect, and what is a per day load one is required? And I think one question which still remains to be answered is, what kind of average cost per unit you have, or maybe the APCs from a customer?
I'm sorry, I didn't get
it. The average cost a customer pays. And if you can give maybe some kind of comparison, because I have many questions and I'm trying to put them together. Okay. What is the kind of average cost that you charge from a customer, and what services are these, if that can be given? And what kind of monthly sales one can expect, considering that, you know, it might take for somebody to reach the break even in say, the next 3 to 4 odd months. And maybe the current times are not as great as maybe a few months back. So how big should be the gestation time? And the other is the average cost.
So the average cost for customer, like per billing, per invoice, is around 1,000 rupees. Like a customer, when he comes, like on an average, he spends minimum 800 to 1,000 rupees.
In a month.
Not a month. One
billings.
Per
transaction. Yeah.
So some customers also spend like 20,000-30,000 per month. Depends on like, you know, HNIs, and depends on people also. So on an average, we've costed like, you know, calculated around 1,000 rupees per order. And any store, like currently we do like minimum 4-5 lakhs to 10 lakhs, depends on like the peak seasons and everything. First store, you can make so much of business from a particular store. Like from October, November, sorry, from August till Feb, we have the peak season. Like, you know, from you have your weddings, you have festivals, you have Diwali, a lot of other festivals. So we have the stores actually run at peak, which is like, you know, they do good around 100, 200 clothes per day. Or say they do like, you know, good 5-6 lakhs minimum in that particular month.
Okay. I think one question which we still missed, I did ask, and I see that coming back again, is what are the absolute margins in the business? You know, what is your cost of servicing and what are the absolute margins which can be retained after taking out all the expenses? And how much should be the rental? How much should be the average salaries of people? And what is the net percentage which remains with the franchisee at the end of the month?
All right. So up the margin after cutting all the costs and all the expenses from rent to electricity to salary and all can depend, like, you know, once you settle, once you pass the break even, it should be around 30%, the revenue, the margin which you're expecting on the revenue. And rent and all depends on the cities and depends on the localities. But generally, we have not much bigger space except for mother store. We require barely like 200 to 300 square feet. Of mother store, we require barely like, you know, 700 square feet or something. So it depends on city to city what the rentals are, what the salaries are. Every city has their own different salaries, margins, and like, you know, different rentals. So it depends city to city how we work out generally. If it's in Pune or some other city, we will work out how the pricing should be and how much you should get, like around minimum 30% margin you can keep and how much you should charge with everything else.
Okay, and all supplies would come from the company?
Yes, all supplies, including detergents, like packing materials and the machineries and everything will be provided by us at cost, at a discounted cost price, because we buy it in bulk and we give it at cost then.
Okay.
So that they don't have to pay extra from the pocket, like, you know, even a rupee. You know.
But I think I'm going through, we have covered almost all the questions. Are you looking at masters outside India? Is one question which I see.
Yes, we are actually. We were planning to start in Dubai.
Okay.
Franchise partner over there. Then we had got inquiries from Sri Lanka, Vietnam and a lot of other places. But yeah, we're looking forward to start in outside India as well.
Just to add, I think Kos has asked the question that is it good time to start in this pandemic period going on? And this question we keep getting. And we have particularly at Franchise India selected businesses, particularly now, which would thrive rather in the times of this crisis. What is happening for all the audience to know is that people are shifting from their regular dhobis, which they didn't trust because they're using or they cleaning wherever they are cleaning to more branded environments. And brand brings a lot of reassurance. That's one. Second, there is also a pickup and drop done from the home. So fundamentally, there's no exposure for a customer to really come down to the outlet and then give the clothes. The collection can be done. So it's a good timing. It's rather a big time and big shift which is happening because a lot of these migrant labor has gone. So there is a lot of shift which is already happening. You know, we're seeing that request. Rather, branded laundries are getting a huge load now these days just because they're conventional people who used to either work at their home to clean the clothes or things of that nature, or they were having trusting the dhobis which used to come, have all, this whole system has disturbed. And now people are actually going and trusting more branded. So it's a great opportunity at this stage for a branded chains to go. And they are very established companies. So they are a brand which is already established. They run their own businesses, their own stores for many, many years. And then now they've started franchising.
So we do actually, like in this COVID times, like there are a lot of people who have, the maids are not there, like the maids are not allowed in the societies or anything. And so they keep coming to our stores and they're like, they feel like, you know, instead of like, you know, getting some things off their hand, some work which they can, like, you know, get it outsourced, which is only one thing which they can outsource, which is laundry. So generally people have started giving us laundries. Once the lockdown opened, they started giving us their laundry to us, thinking like, you know, at least something is off their hands, so they can at least relax a little bit. So during this period also, people are actually giving their laundries and writing to us.
I think one point that we missed, and I also missed that question, is on the royalties. What kind of monthly royalties? Is there a minimum royalty percentage that is charged on the sales, or there's a fixed amount based on the format?
It's the royalty on, like, you know, depends on the model which you select. If you're selecting master franchisee, there's like another percentage of around 10%. And if it's just like collection center or other ongoing store which are running, or you want to acquire those, there are different royalties and different franchise fees on that. So that can be discussed city and, like, you know, depending on the locality.
Okay, great. I think I've tried. I have some more inquiries, but I think we can take these inquiries with you offline. People from MP, there's some parts of North India, and many of the locations which I'm seeing the interest coming in from, including the conversion franchisee. So if we can take up all these inquiries between today, based on your time availability, and we'll like to reach out to all these investors who have shown interest, and align one-on-one call or maybe a Zoom meeting with you to get maybe deeper understanding on the business.
Perfect. Before we close, we would like to have a final word from both of you and also from Sonia. This is a very good business. Someone said, you explain in Hindi. This is a laundry business. It's been many years. Dry cleaning has been many years. Today, it's a lot of demand because people are shifting. Or they are using their homes, which they used to come to their homes. उनके क्लोथ्स को वॉश करता था, उसकी क्वालिटी नहीं होती है और आप स्पेशली ड्राई नहीं कर पाते, और स्पेशली बड़े सिटीज के अंदर ड्राइंग इज वेरी बिग प्रॉब्लम. अभी आजकल मॉनसून चल रहा है, तो मॉनसून में तो और बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है. तो पीपल हैव स्टार्टेड डूइंग एंड सेंडिंग क्लोथ्स आउटसाइड फॉर बोथ फॉर लॉन्ड्री एंड ड्राई क्लीनिंग. एंड और इसके अंदर दो मॉडल हैं. एक मॉडल तो यूनिट फ्रेंचाइज का है, जहां पे आप सिर्फ यूनिट फ्रेंचाइज कर सकते हैं कलेक्शन या लॉन्ड्री का बिजनेस. और एक मास्टर फ्रेंचाइज का मॉडल है, जहां पर आप एक मदर सेंटर क्रिएट करते हैं. मदर सेंटर 70-75 लाख रुपीस में क्रिएट होता है, जिसमें पूरी ड्राई क्लीनिंग की इक्विपमेंट लगता है, लॉन्ड्री का इक्विपमेंट लगता है, एंड स्टीम आयरनिंग का इक्विपमेंट लगता है. इससे आप तीनों चीजें सर्विस कर पाते हैं. जो एक्सपेंसिव क्लोथ्स हैं, जैसे लहंगा हो गया या कोई और सूट्स हो गए, वो ड्राई क्लीनिंग के लिए आते हैं, और जो रेगुलर क्लोथ्स हैं वो लॉन्ड्री के लिए आते हैं, और उसको आप अपना आयरन करके कंज्यूमर को दे सकते हैं. उसके नीचे सारे कलेक्शन सेंटर्स बनते हैं. बहुत पॉपुलर ब्रांड है, एवरीबडी नोज इन बॉम्बे दिस ब्रांड को. और अब ये अपनी दो अपॉर्चुनिटीज को दे रहे हैं. एक अपॉर्चुनिटी है जहां पर आप नए सिटी में फ्रेंचाइज लेना चाहें, बोथ मास्टर या यूनिट. दूसरा ये ले रहे हैं एज एक्सेप्शनल केस फॉर फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया इन्वेस्टर्स. दे हैव ओपनड अप दिस स्पेशल केस कि जहां पर कंपनी के चलते हुए प्रॉफिटेबल स्टोर्स को भी ट्रांसफर करने को कहें. सो अबाउट 10 स्टोर्स वी हैव एग्रीड विच वुड बी गिवन एक्सक्लूसिवली टू फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया ऑडियंस, एंड वी विल बी एबल टू पास दैट. सो प्लीज रीच आउट टू अस. अगर आपका उसमें इंटरेस्ट है, तो हम अंबर जी से और तन्वी से आपकी कॉल सेटअप करवाएंगे. ओवर टू यू तन्वी, वी वुड लाइक टू हियर फ्रॉम यू. सो व्हाट इज योर मैसेज?
So what I would say is, I would like to conclude is that I would really like to inspire all of you all to take that step which has been on your mind for a long time. Take control of a life and become an entrepreneur. Take the step we took 10 years ago, and we look forward to have you on board.
Absolutely. Great message. This is a time where people should take control of their own life and find their
freedom.
And entrepreneurship can not only help your dreams, but also can empower a lot of people which you would hire. So entrepreneurship would save all of us out of this entire thing. So we should all have courage to come out and take an entrepreneurship decision. So over to you, Amber.
So I'm looking forward to hear from everyone, actually, to come and grab this opportunity. Like, it's a very good wide business. You can actually, there's no limit. Sky's the limit to this business. You can, since it's a laundry business, it's now never going to stop. There's now never going to be a slow down or anything or as thought, because people are going to wear their clothes, people are going to wash their clothes, people are going to outsource their laundry. People have changed their mindset of washing clothes at home, which they also, you know, they know, like, you know, it's better and cheaper and like much better to wash the clothes at a laundry, especially a German laundry. So you can just like, you know, it's a very good opportunity to start and like, you know, start your own franchisee in it.
Thank you.
And because you can dry clean yourself.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Ambar and Tanvi. I think a lot of people can even draw a lot of inspiration from both of you. You both are very young and you've been involved in the business, I'm sure, for many, many years, founded by your father. So that's great inspiration for everybody. And entrepreneurship rather grows in times like these. People were asking if this is the right time to start business. And historically, franchising and entrepreneurship have always risen in trying times like this. So we will take up the questions, Ambar and Tanvi, with you. And thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Over to you, Arshana.
Thank you so much, Ms. Tanvi Rawl. Thank you so much, Mr. Ambar, for joining us today. We would like to extend our thanks to all the participants who have joined and have understood the business model for BOT as well as for new expansion. We would like to thank Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am as usual for their rich experience, insights and valuable suggestions they share with us. But before we go, recorded version of this particular webinar and all the previously conducted webinar is available at the FB page, that is Facebook page of Franchisee India Brands Limited. Please remember, it's Franchisee India Brands Limited, and you can connect with us on all social links which is there at your chat tool. You can also connect with us at the business hotline number, which is 97176-83838. It's very simple, 97176-83838. You will directly get a call within 2 hours from our side. That's the assurance from our side. We are happy to help you with any kind of the suggestion, feedback, and all the queries. Stay safe. Thank you so much. And join us tomorrow for another great webinar. Best wishes from our side. Thank you so much, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, Tanvi. Thank you, Ambar.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Sonia. Thank you, Gaurav. Thank you.
Thanks.